Hello everyone, welcome to Fort City Commerce class. In this video, I am discussing time series, which is one of the interesting topic in statistics. Here, I am giving introductory aspects of time series and one of the method in measurement of trend, that is graphic method. Let's start. Meaning of time series. As the name only suggests, time series means in the series where one variable is time. Series means the data which is arranged in a specific order. In the statistics, we will see the three kinds of series. In those series, one variable, there might be one or two or three variables or more than three variables in a series where one variable should be the time. Those series are called as a time series. And a time series where the data is arranged according to time in a chronological order means arranging earliest is first and next they are going to follow the order. Majorly why we need time series means to make forecast about the future values and also we can evaluate the past performance. Here is an example for time series where year is a time indicating time. It may be a year, it may be the months, it may be the dates or it may be the clock timings also. So it should mention the time. And one of the other variable is production. So this kind of series are called as a time series. And it is arranged in a chronological order. So we can see that 2016 is earliest. Next 2017, it follows the order. Normally it is in equal intervals. That is 2016, next we have to get the 2017, not 2018 directly. So if we take 2016, 2018, then we have to take 2020. So normally it is of equal interval. Components of time series. There are four components in time series. First one is secular trend. In time series, normally we have two variables where one variable represents the time and another variable we call it as y. It may be any of the variable. So the variable y in secular trend follows the long-term tendency, either it may be in upward motion or it may be in a downward movement, and it also varies over a long period of time. For example, the population trend, inflationary trend, birth rate, and so on. These variables follows upward movement. If we take mortality rate, it is taking downward movement. It is usually decreasing in nature, either increasing in nature. Those kind of variables are called as a secular trend or trend variables. Next one is cyclical time series. This type of time series regularly follows swing or pattern that repeat over a long period of time. The moments are usually occurs more than a 1 year. For example, if you take business cycles, the stages will move. It is following the swing pattern and it usually takes more than 1 year to complete the whole cycle, to pass from the whole stages of business cycles. It is not going to complete within the 1 year period. So more than 1 year a period should be there for a cyclical time series. Next one is seasonal time series. In seasonal time series, patterns of change that repeat over a period of 1 year means within 1 year these cyclical movements will occur. For example, the demand for crackers at the time of Deepavali or demand for the books or stationery items at the starting of academic year. This will finish up within a 1 year. Again in the next year, the same thing will be followed. That kind of series are called as a seasonal time series. And the last component is irregular time series. In this kind of time series, variations are occurred in the y variable because of some chance factors, and it is unpredictable also. For example, any changes in demand because of floods, wars, strikes or droughts may be the example for are the examples for irregular time series. Next topic is measurement of trend. There are four components in time series. That is, first one is secular trend. How we can measure the trend? So there are four methods from which we can measure the trend. First one is graphical method. Second one is semi-average method. Third one is moving average method. And the last one is least squares method. So these are all the methods we use for measuring the trend. I will discuss it one by one. The first method in measurement of trend is graphic or freehand method. It is the simplest method and flexible method in measurement of trend. In this method, first we have to plot the data on the graph paper. In this graph, x-axis represents the years and y-axis represents the variable y. Then we have to plot the time series value on the graph. So there are total four values, and those four values are marked and they are joined through a straight line. Then we have to draw a trend line which represents a long-term tendency of the data. When we are drawing a trend line, we have to consider three points. The first point is, when we draw a trend line, the number of points above the trend line and the number of points below the trend line more or less equal, which means when we draw a trend line, in this trend line we can see that there are 2 points above the trend line and 2 points below the trend line. If in case of odd values, if the y values are 5 in number, then you can draw a trend line 3 points above the trend line and 2 points below, or you can also draw a trend line 2 points above the trend line and 3 points below the trend line. It should be more or less equal. Some variations are acceptable. The next condition is the total of positive deviation more or less equal to sum of negative deviations. The positive deviations means the values which is above the trend line represents the positive deviation. The values below the trend line represents the negative deviations. In this graph, you can see that for the value 5, the positive deviation, because it is above the trend line, how much deviation is there means the difference is 0.75, that is positive one. And also for this point, you can see it is also positive because it is above the line. So the deviation, that is the difference between these 2 points, the trend line value and the actual value, is plus 0.9, and the values below the trend line represents the negative deviation. So here you can see that the value 4 and the value of trend value is more, so that's why there is a negative deviation of minus 0.75, and here the minus 1 is the negative deviation. What they say, the total of positive deviation, that is the total of positive deviation is 0.75 plus 0.9 equals 1.65, is the sum of positive deviation, and the sum of negative deviation is minus 1.75, so which is more or less equal. We can't do always equal, cannot be done. Sometimes it like slight variation can be acceptable. Here 1.65, here 1.75, so signs should be ignored. So more or less they are equal. This condition should be satisfied. And the third condition is, the sum of the squares of the deviation should be minimum possible, which means first we have to square the values of deviation, that is 0.75, minus 0.75 and 0.9 and minus 1. So first we have to square all these values, then we have to add these values. So when we add those values, we got the value 2.9350, which should be minimum as possible. Okay, take for example, if we draw the trend line in this method, so the first condition is not satisfied, where the number of points above the trend line is only 1, but the number of trend values below the trend line is 3. So the first condition is not satisfied. If we take another example of another trend line which is in downward movement, here also you can see that the number of points above is only 1. The number of points below the trend line is 3. So it is also not satisfying the first condition. So it is not acceptable trend line. Another one example, this line is satisfying the first condition, that is the two values above and the two values below the trend line is there, but the deviation, that is the positive deviation, is more as compared to negative deviation. It is not satisfying the second and third condition. So when we are drawing the trend line, we should keep these three points and we should write this line. We should draw this line. So there is no need of mathematical calculation for this method. Just to understanding purpose, I did all this calculation. Just we have to draw a trend line. This is one of the example problem for graphic method. Here the time series table is given, that is year, and sales figures in thousands. Let's draw a graph now. First, while doing the graph, we have to write scale, heading, and what x-axis represents and what y-axis represents. The scale should be written on the top of it. The scale is for x-axis, 1 centimeter equals to 1 year, and for y-axis, 1 centimeter equals to 20,000 rupees. And x-axis represents year, and the y-axis represents sales. Sales figures were represents in y-axis. So then we have to draw a trend line. Then we have to draw, first we have to plot the values. So there are total 11 values. All those 11 values are plotted on the graph according to the scale. So now we have to draw a trend line. The trend line I have taken like this. See here, in this trend line, there are total 11 values were there. So there are total 6 points are above the trend line and 5 points below the trend line. You can also draw a trend line where the 5 points above the trend line and 6 points below the trend line. It is based on your decision. So like this you can draw a trend line. That's it for the graphic method. Just you have to plot the data on the graph and you have to draw a trend line by considering the 3 points in your mind. Merits of this method is it is simple to understand, easy to calculate, time saving, and it doesn't require any mathematical calculations, and it is very flexible method also. But it suffers lot of limitations also because it is not giving any accurate results, and just the trend line is drawn based on the number of points, and it is not helpful for forecasting the results, and it is subjective because the trend line is drawn based on their own judgment. I can draw the trend line one way and another one can draw in another way. So it is not same for everyone. That's why it is not helpful for forecasting also. That is the main disadvantage of this method. So we have the next method called semi-average method, and it is discussed in later videos. Thank you for watching. I hope this video is helpful for you. Thank you.